My name is Pietro Sciortino, and here we are in my workshop where I spend the whole day happily in the company of art. I work on the wood that is treated, I make the surface smooth, and then I start my drawing.
Allora, io uso delle tavole di legno, quindi lavoro sul legno.
I make drafts that are not final, but that I change constantly depending on my inspiration.
Nel caso specifico, questa è una soffitta.
For example, this is an attic where there are various objects, such as maiolica, the doors of a Sicilian cart, my brushes, a Pinocchio, and who knows what else I will add.
Sono dei colori all'inizio molto vivaci, però poi faccio delle velature.
I start with very bright colors and then I do some glazing that makes the work look aged. They must be lived works, as if catapulted into the past. I work mainly with acrylic paints.
Devono diventare appunto delle opere vissute, che danno anche una loro importanza, cioè danno una visione quasi vissuta del passato. È un rifugio, però difficilmente io qui rimango da solo.
My workshop is like a refuge, but in reality many friends come to visit me and we spend afternoons together just chatting. We are in the historic center of Palermo and many people stop by, foreigners and Sicilians, in a cheerful atmosphere. Many schools pass by and I am happy to have contact with young people to share my art. Young people, as it happened to me, need to learn about and to be curious.
E ho raccontato molto, soprattutto molto della mia Palermo, della mia città, della mia Sicilia.
I have told a lot about Palermo, my city. I made works that I called attics, where people put their memories, their emotions, their treasures. My works are very dreamlike, almost childlike, surreal, emotional world.
Per esempio, mi chiedono, ma come mai tu hai messo il Pinocchio? Che non è un giocattolo nostro.
They ask me, why you put Pinocchio, which is not a Sicilian toy? I made him ours, Sicilian, by making him travel in Sicily. For example, in the catacombs of Palermo, where he found the famous Rosalia. Pinocchio also went to visit the puppeteers, and then I took him to Caltanissetta and the Sulphur Mines.
Per esempio, è andato a trovare le catacombe di Palermo, dove ha incontrato Rosalia Lombardo. Sono delle maioliche nostre siciliane.
I fell in love with ancient Sicilian maiolica by visiting ancient palaces in Palermo. This 18th century Sicilian maiolica are wonderful. Mine is a seemingly fairy tale world, but fairy tales are often messages for adults. Many people ask me why I often represent Palermo in my works. Palermo is a beautiful city, a bit of a prostitute and a bit of a noblewoman. It gives you and takes you away. I love it with all its merits and effects.
La follia è un mondo fantastico, è un mondo quasi surreale. La follia, alle volte dicono, ma i folli vedono delle cose che in realtà altri non vedono, ma è la verità.
Madness is a fantastic, surreal way, and I find myself in it perfectly. In madness you see things that others don't see.
Sono 30 anni ormai che lavoro nel mondo della pittura.
I've been doing this job for 30 years and I have only realized how much time has passed when I looked at this monograph. I started with the Houses of Tolerance here in Palermo. even if I don't know why, maybe out of curiosity to peer into a world that didn't belong to me. And so I researched, interviewed, visited. And this made me realize that before creating a work of art, I had to document myself. I made 30 portraits of the corpses of the famous Capuchin catacombs in Palermo. For me, it was very touching because my father, in order to feed his family during the war, took sacks of flour and, pursued by the Germans, took refuge in the catacombs. And was saved by a priest who hid him inside a dead man's coffin.
I tedeschi se ne accorsero e lui scappò e si rifugiò all'interno delle catacombe. Cioè un sacerdote lo aiutò e rimase chiuso dentro una cassa con un cadavere. A me è rimasta sta curiosità di vedere e immaginare mio padre all'interno di queste catacombe al buio.
When I returned to these Capuchin catacombs, I saw my father again in those sad moments. I understood that often you don't have to go in search of something. It will be this something that will arrive. You just have to have the ability to grasp it, to catch the inspiration.
E alle volte non bisogna necessariamente andare alla ricerca di qualche cosa, è qualcosa che ti arriva. Mm-hmm. Bisogna avere la capacità di afferrarla e di farlo.